model question is based on tides, specifically tides in two regions, one Bay of Fundy of Nova Scotia, as well as the second one, Southampton in England, right? Now this question is made from NCRT. These statements are taken from NCRT itself, right? Now it's a two statement question, and going through the first one, the Bay of Fundy of Nova Scotia has the largest tidal range in the world, right? Here the conceptual related term is the tidal range. Now tidal range or range means difference between maximum as well as minimum, right? Range of anything, right? Range of temperature, difference between highest temperature and the lowest temperature. So tidal range means like, you know, the difference between high tide as well as low tide, right? So that difference we call it as tidal range. Now the Bay of Fundy, which is located towards the eastern coast of North America, is a bay in the sense it's closed on one region, right? And so what happens is that when tide comes, all the water will gush in towards this bay because it's having wide mouth. As well as like when lower tide comes, right, all the water will be retrieved from the bay in the sense creating much lower low tide, right? That means if you are having higher high tide and if you are having lower low tide, right, we will be having high tidal range. Now it's a fact based question which is given in NCERT. The Bay of Fundy is having largest the tidal range, right? Now moving on to the second statement, in Southampton along the southern coast of England, tides occur 4 times a day. Now tides means like, you know, the periodic rise and fall in sea level, that we call it as tides, and they are under the influence of gravitational attraction of moon, gravitational attraction of sun, as well as the centrifugal force of earth, right, because of the rotation of the earth. Now ideally a region should experience tide twice a day, right? In the sense, you know, if you're going by the ideal thing, right, like the without considering the configuration of landmass or anything, we should be having tides twice a day, okay? But in the case of Southampton, the statement is saying they are experiencing tides occurring, they're having tides 4 times per day, right? Now going through the region, right, if you're looking at the Southampton, this region is connected with the open ocean through the English Channel as well as through the North Sea. So what happens is that, imagine these regions when they are having the higher tide, the tidal water will rush in to the Southampton, right? Now imagine this English Channel, right, this region is also having higher tide. In that scenario also, the water will gush in towards the Southampton region. In effect, this region is not like the normal regions, rather than they experience tides 4 times a day. 4 times in the sense, like, you know, one through the North Sea, right, one high tide, then another high tide through the English Channel. Now one low tide through the English Channel and another low tide through the North Sea. In effect, they are having 4 tides per day, right? So again, like going back to the question, in Southampton along the southern coast of England, tides occur 4 times a day, which is true, right? And there is a tendency that, you know, from oceanography, right, this tides, they are related with oceanography. If you go through all the previous questions in oceanography, they are taken from the NCERT itself, right? And this statement is given, since they are given in NCERT, right, make sure you keep these facts in mind, right? Highest tidal range in world is in Bay of Fundy in Nova Scotia, and the Southampton is having 4 times, tides 4 times a day, right, because of they are connected to the open sea, both through the English Channel as well as through the North Sea. So here answer comes out as C, which is both 1 and 2.